Sup, Trophy Hunters, King Suporns just signed in, and welcome to the December edition of the Flash Sale. Let's get this started. So this bundle is most likely a trap. Don't know much about Destiny 2 for the trophies, but not sure if it's even worth getting. Overwatch, it's a lot of online shit you gotta do, and then Black Ops 4, I guess it's probably worth it, but this is too many zombie bullshit you gotta deal with. Too expensive. Fuck do I want VC for? Even when it's $40, it's still too expensive. Why is there a Battlefield 5 upgrade for $6? What the fuck does it even come with? Like, so stupid, but it's too expensive. When the fuck did they even release The Force on the PS4? Last time I checked, I see a YouTuber playing this, and it just looked like a piece of shit game. What the fuck? Oh, hell no. If it was like $5, I'll get it, but nah, I'm good. Too expensive, even though I'm not getting that. Fuck that. Now, I really want to get a Madden game and actually play one, but ever since Madden NFL 2005, when they have the Baltimore Raven, Ray Lewis in there, I will wait until they release a Madden game that has a Redskins or a Raven footballer, and I'll buy that day one. But right now, I'm good with 11 and 17, and that's all I'm gonna have for now. I would get this, but if it was cheaper, I would buy it. I still want to platinum a hockey game, so I'm going to keep an eye on NHL 19 or any other NHL game and see what do I need to do to even platinum one hockey game. But that right there is too expensive. So apparently this game is kind of like Super Meat Boy. I have no idea what this game is all about. I don't know what it is, but I'm not paying $10 for that shit, so fuck that. Every single time I look at this game and it's always on sale, it really makes me want to buy it, but at the same time, I'm not even sure if I really want to get into the game. Because I'm already playing like a lot of Call of Duties, and this is just looks like another Call of Duty to me. So yeah, I don't know if it's worth the money or not, but you know what? I'll let you guys decide if you guys want to get it. When you see a Castlevania game, you hit X, you add the cart, you continue shopping, you hit circle, and you keep it going. Would love to get that, but it's too fucking expensive. Not even gonna take that damn risk. How many fucking Jackbox parties are gonna fucking make? Like, what the fuck? This is another Just Dance now? Like, Jesus Christ. Only if they have anyone from the Washington Wizards, I'll get it. But as of now, no. Obviously, I'm just gonna wait for the full release of this game and then just get it when it's on sale. I'm pretty sure this was on the holiday sale, but okay, I mean, I was gonna get it anyways. Oh, what do you know? Speaking of Just Dance, it's right there. Should I get it? Fuck no. I would absolutely love to get this in the season pass. I just wanna wait till it's cheaper. And besides, I have all the other Tomb Raiders I gotta play anyways. Same thing with Far Cry 5. Right now, 2 is just staring at me in the face, telling me to finish the online trophies. Fuck, man, I don't even want to run up and down the stairs shooting the fuckers in the head. True story. My friend Bo-Ping, this was the last game he ever played or even talk about when it comes to like the newest games that ever came out. So, I really want to platinum this game dedicated to him, but $14.99, I don't know about that. I might just borrow the game or something like that, but I'm going to platinum this game just for him. Rest in peace, Bo. Yeah, you know, I got that Pro Evolution Soccer 2011 offline trophy stackable games. Yeah, I might just do that instead. Fuck 2019, since Konami can't even fucking make any good games nowadays. Except Super Bomberman R. Thank God. Thank you, Konami. Thank you for actually keeping Bomberman alive. Thank you. The hell is a Marching Fire Edition? I didn't even know they're still making For Honor. Thought they were done with that shit. Oh, what do you know? We had Ride to Hell 2, now Ride to Hell 3. I would definitely buy the game if it was cheaper. Same with Yakuza 6. If that was cheaper, I would definitely buy it. This game looks like the next Need for Speed. I don't know what it is, but I would definitely get it if it was cheaper. That just looked like the most gayest thing I have ever seen ever. I don't even know if I even want to even purchase it. If it was even free on Plus, that's the only time I'll ever play the game. But fuck that shit. What is this Dakar 18? What the fuck is this MotoGP remix? Fucking WRC remix? Like what is going on with these random ass racing games? It just looked like a ripoff of another racing game. How do I know Grip is like the next Grid? It may be the same developer. I don't even know, man. What the fuck is this? What is Starlink? Is that like the next Star Trek? Or is it like Destiny with actual airplane shooting? Like, I don't even know. Boundless just looks like the Venus level of Destiny 1. Like, what the fuck? Omen of Sorrow just looks like a Devil May Cry slash Hellblade ripoff. I don't even know, man. Like, they just released games that I don't even fucking know what the hell they do. And then these last four games, I mean, what am I gonna, I don't know any of these games. Is it even worth my time even getting any of them? Maybe next time they're on the flash sale, I'll actually look it up to see what they are. But right now, I'm not giving a shit about any of these games. It's probably just Castlevania and The Crew 2 is the only thing that's worth my time even getting in this damn fucking flash sale video. But okay, that's basically it. I don't think they even had a PS3 flash sale, but oh well, I guess that's basically it. So, final results. With two games purchased, I have spent a total of $34.78. Stay tuned for the next splash sale video as you are listening to the best Trophy Hunter ever. Period.